هيا على الفلاح. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, when a person passes away, leaving behind some wealth, the estate of the deceased needs to be sorted out in a way that creates comfort and not a disaster. So remember, there will be orphans, there will be widows, there will be boys and girls, brothers and sisters, children, sons and daughters, whoever it may be, subhanallah. Allah warns us about that wealth, and Allah says, solve the matter, sort it out with justice, and don't cheat or deceive anyone. Also, don't unnecessarily delay. Any of these things would actually cause a huge disaster in your home. It would drive people away from each other. It would split the relationships within the broader family. Remember, if you want to please Allah, you will definitely have to do as Allah has instructed. And if you do that, you will achieve a lot of comfort, and you will even protect yourselves from falling into a crisis in the first place. And this is why Allah says in Surah An-Nisa, which is a surah that is named after the women, He mentions all the laws of inheritance in great detail in this surah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَآتُوا الْيَتَامَىٰ أَمْوَالَهُمْ وَلَا تَتَبَدَّلُوا الْخَبِيثَ بِالطَّيِّبِ. And give the orphans their wealth. Now when Allah is instructing you, it means it's supposed to happen quickly. Allah says, give them their wealth. And don't cheat them. Don't eat their wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't swap their wealth that is good with yours that is not so good. If they have something and it's really a good thing, and because they're young, because they're vulnerable, women, girls, the daughters, the orphans, the young, because they don't know so much about the wealth that is left behind, many people tend to cheat them. They deceive them. They delay giving them their wealth. They find it very difficult to let go. Well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us all in this regard, and He actually names the surah of the women, to ensure that you did not maltreat them. This is part of the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want goodness, you need to ask yourself, am I doing something wrong? If you're in a crisis, if you have a major issue in your life, the first question you need to ask yourself always is, am I on the right page in my relationship with Allah? If not, what am I doing wrong? Have I harmed someone? Have I oppressed someone? Have I wronged someone? Did I steal someone's wealth? Primarily, the orphans and the widows. Those are categories of people who are taken care of by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself. He personally ensures that they will be taken care of. And therefore, anyone who oppresses them, who does wrong to them, they will never have comfort in their lives in the long term, and at times even in the short term. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, you know what? Give the women their due, give the men their due, don't cheat anyone, and make sure that you have not consumed hellfire in your belly. In verse number 10, Allah says,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَأْكُلُونَ أَمْوَالَ الْيَتَامَى ظُلْمًا إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ نَارًا وَسَيَصْلَوْنَ سَعِيرًا.
Those who have consumed the wealth of the orphans oppressively in a wrong way, they've consumed that wealth, they have eaten in their bellies nothing besides the flames of hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So Allah says, for them there is doom, doom. Imagine Allah's telling you, the doom is for a person who did this. So if you feel you're doomed, ask yourself, did I do this? If you didn't, inshallah, things are okay. But if you have done wrong, my brothers and sisters, no matter who you are, this is the time to resolve your matters of inheritance between you, your family members, your children, your nephews and nieces, your brothers, your uncles and aunts, your parents, and whoever else it may be, the widow, the orphans. This is the time to resolve the crisis. Because if you want the mercy of Allah, make sure that you've given the dues to whomsoever they belong to. So much so When a person works for us, if we were to delay their salary, do you know we are asking for trouble? Do you know that we are asking for the curse of Allah? Because we are supposed to be making the payment as soon as the work is done or as per the agreement. If you have delayed or you abuse a person working for you, or you are not paying them and there is no reason why you should not pay them, then remember, you are tampering with something that is very, very delicate in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To give the wealth where it is due is a way of solving your crises in your own home, your health and everything else. And this is why we're taught to give charity. In order to come out of difficulty, we're taught to give charity. Imagine you haven't even given the farad, that which is compulsory, the dues. And you think that you're going to get a solution by being charitable? More important than all those charities is to resolve the $5 that you owe the brother or the sister. That is far more important than all the charities you may be throwing left, right, and center. Because in Allah's eyes, He wants you to do that which is compulsory before you do that which is voluntary. What is the point of someone making or praying the voluntary prayers called nafil or sunnah when they haven't even done the farad or that which was compulsory? So that foolishness, Allah says, don't allow that to actually overtake you. You will pay as a result of this. And remember, the payment is not done immediately in all cases, because Allah wants to give you a chance to resolve the problems. Allah wants to give you a chance to come back before He overtakes you with any form of hardship. So Allah says, I won't punish this person immediately. I'm going to give them time. So if you've done wrong and you think you're getting away with it, you're actually not. Allah's waiting for the right time. It may affect you now and it may affect you later. Before crying tears of blood, my brothers and sisters, what does it cost you to solve the problem? Pick up the phone today and sort the matter out with those whom you have a matter with, if it is financial, especially the issue of inheritance. So much so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whosoever cheats anyone when it comes to inheritance or delays them or deceives them, then they are cursed and perhaps they may be cast into hellfire in the hereafter for a very, very long time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. My brothers and sisters, it's very important for us to be fair and balanced. When we are just, we will achieve justice, we will achieve goodness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says He wants to forgive us. It's not like Allah wants to punish us. The same surah in Surah An-Nisa, verse number 27, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاللَّهُ يُرِيدُ أَن يَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ وَيُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ أَن تَمِيلُوا مَيْلًا عَظِيمًا. Allah says, and Allah wants to forgive you. Imagine, Allah wants to forgive you. People who commit sin, people who do wrong, people who've cheated and deceived, whether it is inheritance or otherwise, Allah says, I want to forgive you, so come, seek forgiveness, make amends, sort your matters out, and you will be forgiven. So Allah says, but you know what? Those who want to follow their desires, and those who want to follow their lusts, what they love, they want you to actually turn away from Allah, a great turning. So Allah says, يُرِيدُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الشَّهَوَاتِ. Those who want to follow their own immoral lusts and desires, whether it's for wealth or for the opposite sex or whatever it may be. Allah says, they want to influence you to be able to turn you away from Allah. But as for Allah, He wants to forgive you. He loves you enough to forgive you, but seek that forgiveness and make amends. And this is why Allah says, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ أَن يُخَفِّفَ عَنْكُمْ وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. The very next verse, Allah says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make the burden light on you, because He knows man has been created very weak. Man is weak. Man tends to love things, and out of his love for material things, he's ready to compromise his link with Allah. Allah says, don't allow that to happen. Yes, we know you love things. Get them in the legitimate ways if you can. If you cannot, bear patience. Life is very short. You will not have everything on earth. Even the wealthiest person wants more. And even the person who has what you would like to have still wants much more than what they have. So it's a rat race that doesn't stop. Allah says, man has been created weak. Be patient. Develop your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bear patience. And understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to make things easy for you. So if you're just, you pass the test. If you are fair and balanced, you pass the test. Even if you haven't achieved so much materially, Allah will give you contentment. Allah will give you comfort. But if you've achieved a lot through means that are not legitimate, that is short-lived. That is very short-lived. That is actually foolish. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, don't eat each other's wealth wrongly. Verse number 29, Allah says,
يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تأكلوا أموالكم بينكم بالباطل إلا أن تكون تجارة عن تراض منكم.
O you who believe, don't consume each other's wealth wrongly, in a deceptive way, in a wrong way, unless you're doing business with each other. That's the only time you can rightfully consume wealth. Otherwise, you should not be doing that. So Allah is telling you, even in business, don't shortchange people. Don't cheat. Don't deceive. One of the biggest deceptions is المنفق سلعته بالحلف الكاذب.
A person who sells his commodity, taking a false oath about its cost price. Then Allah says, you're going to pay a price for using our name to do something cheap. You use the name of Allah to lie to a customer about your cost price. There will be no blessings in that sale or in the profit you've made. You actually cheated. So Allah says, don't do that to each other. You actually want comfort in crisis and you want to be protected from crisis in the first place. Then protect yourself by being honest in business, upright. Even if your profit is less, for as long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you, you have nothing to worry about. May Allah make it easy for every single one of us. And may Allah grant us the ability to resolve our matters of inheritance today. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who are just and fair at all times and who help each other achieve that which is correct. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على.
Thank you so much for listening to this short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.